can help me!
Here is the band of criminals that was the Axis leadership at the beginning of the war. Adolf Hitler, Führer of the Third Reich, the man who personifies true evil. Benito Mussolini, an incompetent thug who sold out his own people. Hermann Göring, the decadent Reich Marshal in charge of the Luftwaffe. And Heinrich Himmler, head of the Nazi SS who oversaw the greatest crimes against humanity. Himmler was a mentally unstable man who truly believed the crazy mythology that he and his fellow SS deviants created in their efforts to establish an independent state within Nazi Germany. Unfortunately, Himmler took his own life before he could be brought to trial, unlike Göring, who was convicted and sentenced to death at the Nuremberg War Crimes Tribunal, and who is no doubt spending eternity with the rest of his friends.
There's a new mission that's suddenly opened up, but it's strictly on a volunteer basis. This is the town of Cassino, the gateway to Rome. And this is the abbey that sits above Cassino, on a small mountain that is the most strategic spot in a most strategic town. The Allies have been stuck here for weeks, unable to take the hill or the abbey from the Germans, and time is running out. Unlike the ruins on Crete, command has made the decision that it's time to attack the site from the air, no matter the consequences to history or scholarship. The abbey has been there for over 1400 years, and tomorrow it's going to be bombed into oblivion. Now, here's where it gets complicated. Just within the last hour, we finished translating a message that was transmitted from the abbey last night. It was written in, of all things, Latin. What it says is quite troubling. The author claims to be a monk sympathetic to the Allied cause, someone who doesn't want to see any more loss of life on either side. Now here's the really distressing part. The monk claims that there are several downed American pilots being held inside as prisoners of war. He says they're confined to cells in the old part of the abbey and would surely be killed in a raid. There certainly have been a lot of airmen from the 8th Air Force lost over Italy, so the monk's claim is not without merit. But let me be clear, Manon. We don't have any independent confirmation of the monk's story, or if he even is a monk. The language and diction check out, but the Nazis have fooled us before. This all just might be a clever ruse on their part to prevent an aerial bombardment. The mission is fairly straightforward. Clandestinely infiltrate the Abbey, rescue the POWs, and disrupt the Germans' operation by destroying whatever equipment you can. The monk's message contained very specific instructions on how to sneak inside, which you can read on the plane if you accept this mission.
what took you so long.
Warte!
The European air war that started with the RAF in the Battle of Britain was continued by the forces of the Army Air Corps. Nimble fighters piloted by brave young men roamed the countryside, attacking any target of opportunity, disrupting the German war machine on the ground and in the air, while heavy American bombers made daring daylight raids against the Third Reich. But there was a heavy price to be paid. By war's end, almost one out of every 10 Americans killed had been a member of the 8th Air Force.
Welcome back, Manon. Things around here are going to get even more hectic than they were before. The OSS is recruiting a new agent for a very specialized mission, and I think we've got our man. Remember that young ADC pilot who got you out of North Africa a year and a half ago? A lieutenant named Jimmy Patterson? I've kept my eye on him since then, and lo and behold, he just got himself nominated for the Medal of Honor. I'm going to see him tomorrow. If he decides to accept our offer, I want to make you his boss. My gut tells me the two of you will make a good team. Not all the details of his mission have been worked out yet, but I do know that it's got something to do with the Nazis' vengeance weapons program, which brings us to the subject of your next assignment, the V-1 buzz bomb. We've received mixed intelligence over the past 2 years about their efforts to build a long-range, self-guiding flying bomb, so we weren't sure they'd ever be able to manufacture these weapons in mass quantities. Unfortunately, as we discovered this past week, they have. One of these V-1s, powered by its pulse jet engine, can travel from its launch site in the French countryside to the heart of London in about 15 minutes. Some Spitfires on patrol have been able to knock down a few in midair, but for the most part, they get through to the city without any trouble. A few of these things have hit near my office at Whitehall, and I can tell you firsthand that it's not a pleasant experience. Some of the junior staff were at a pub that got hit. The impact crater was big enough to park a Liberty ship inside. No traces of the men were ever found. As soon as the 8th Air Force takes out a launch site, new ones spring up like weeds somewhere else. They've even air-launched a few of these missiles from specially modified Luftwaffe bombers. We've got to put a stop to this. Your mission is to disrupt their V-1 manufacturing line and to secure the deployment information for the bombs that have already been shipped out. You leave tonight at 1900 hours. Be careful, Manon, or I'll have to find someone else to watch over this Patterson kid.
Travis, you made it. Here are the plans for the factory. Let's go. It's not safe here.